Architects go through this process of designing people's lifestyles, and we never really actually live those lifestyles.
University of Minnesota graduate student Molly Eagen sees that as a problem. And since she's an architect herself, Molly is in the position to do something about it. So she started with a question.
Why don't I live out a scenario of a post-Euclid world?
Molly decided she would study how people would be forced to live without easy access to cheap oil by not using any petroleum-based products or any petroleum-supported infrastructure for a period of 100 days. As it turns out, it was not easy.
Without cheap oil, we can't have this, or we can only use this much water, and we can only use this much energy. We can only transport ourselves walking or biking around.
The obvious changes Molly had to endure were no more driving or riding in cars or taking buses. There's also the inability to use or buy any plastics. Not easy to do if you like to eat food.
The cardboard wasn't a problem, but the ink on the cardboard printed on the box is made out of petroleum. So all of a sudden that's something I can't use. Anything wrapped in plastic I couldn't eat. Couldn't buy a bag of chips, like something in saran wrap. I couldn't store food in saran wrap or Tupperware.
Once she was done with the food she could eat, well, Molly couldn't just take it out with the trash.
We have to truck around all this waste. Garbage trucks have the lowest miles per gallon of basically any vehicle on the road.
So everything had to be composted. Recycling wasn't allowed either. Even water, which uses fuel in the transportation, cleaning, and/or heating process, meant cold bucket showers.
As the season gets colder, all of a sudden waking up in the morning and taking a cold bucket shower, because I couldn't heat this water, of course, wasn't that appealing anymore.
Molly talked about every step of the journey on her blog and in her soon-to-be-released book, both titled 100 Days Without Oil. And she's not just taking notes or doing this project for the joy of it. Molly is a graduate student in the University of Minnesota's College of Design. The lessons she learned from her time without oil are part of her research work for the U of M. Molly says the ability to do a project like this as part of her academic program makes the U a perfect fit for her.
It was probably the most socially conscious program that I came across. You know, they were more focused on social economic issues and environmental issues than most of the schools I looked at.
Molly's advisors allowed her to take the unique approach of using herself as a subject in the research, something Molly says architects and designers might consider doing more often.
Because we're designing lifestyles, basically we have to experience those lifestyles before we propose that somebody live that way.
Using that firsthand knowledge, Molly can now begin work on designing systems that facilitate more sustainable lifestyles. For example, shelving better suited to buying bulk local ingredients. She can offer advice on how to design cities for easy bicycle and pedestrian transportation. She can talk about the impact that packaging makes, or about water usage or waste disposal. And she's not done.
The Three Actions Project is basically an attempt to gather, the kind of experience that I had with 200 or 300 people.
Molly knows her experience was extreme, and she's not suggesting society as a whole could or should try living that way. Which is why she's now focusing on the Three Actions Project, a project where volunteers will give up 3 fossil fuel-based conveniences for a period of time, similar to what Molly did, just not as extensive. The experiences of the participants will help inform real-world environmental policy and infrastructure changes.
And they focus on those things and commit to changing those things for a couple months of their life.
Meanwhile, Molly is focused on wrapping up the research on her own experience.
It was both like really depressing because I realized what a huge change I was going to have to be, but it was also sort of empowering to think that as designers, we have the power to change those things, and it is up to us, to sort of be addressing, but first understanding what the real issues are.